This video is for an impressive gamer named Swordless Link. This concerns the game, The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. It's been known to many that he has written glitch FAQs about this game and Super Mario 64 DS, and has demonstrated how to do the glitches.
What's up YouTube, it's Gupsel89 once again. Now this video is going to show you something strange involving the glitches in my game of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. But before I get to that, there's something that you should know. There are different Nintendo 64 versions of the game, and the changes from version to version involve the changes of content and the removal of some glitches. Now, I said before that I'm going to talk about the glitches, and I'm going to show you something important before I get to the game. So here's the important thing. I'm going to read a few sections in the Version Differences FAQ by Swordless Link himself. The link to this document is in the description window. The first section I'm going to read is How to Determine Your Version. The first paragraph reads, Note, this only applies to NTSC or North American copies of the N64 cartridge. If you have a PAL copy, Europe or Australia, then you have version 1.2, as PAL is exactly the same as NTSC version 1.2. The second paragraph reads, The simplest way to determine what version you have is to look at the cartridge. On the front sticker at the bottom in the center is a two-lined code. The bottom line of this code differs between V1.0, V1.1, and V1.2. Here's what the code is for each version. Version 1.0 is NUS-CZGE-USA. V1.1 is NUS-CZLE-USA. And version 1.2 is almost exactly like V1.1, except that there is a parenthetical 0 and 1 added at the end. There is an important note included after the listings. If you have a gold cartridge and it's an NTSC one, then it is definitely version 1.0. If you have a PAL Australian one, despite it being gold, it is the same as V1.2 and not V1.0. Now we skip down to the glitches section. V1.0 has every known glitch, obviously including the infamous Swordless glitch and the Steal the Rod glitch. V1.1 has the original Swordless glitch and the Steal the Rod removed. And V1.2 is the same as V1.1 in terms of glitches. Just to give you a little rundown of what I'm going to do, I'm going to follow the instructions coming up in just a second. The Swordless glitch, which is exclusive to V1.0, is activated through the following method. At the final battle with Ganon, after he knocks your sword out of your hands, pause, save, and reset. When you reload your file, you'll be at the foot of the tower of the castle with your sword unequipped. Now when you get on Epona, you can use any C item while on her. A pretty fun glitch. The next set of instructions will also be followed. The Steal the Rod glitch, also exclusive to V1.0, can be activated through the following two methods. I'm only going to follow the first method. As Adult Link, go fishing in the pond in Lake Hylia and equip the hover boots. Run onto the water and while hovering, cast the fishing rod. You can now walk around with the rod cast and can leave the pond without the man stopping you. This is the only copy of the game that I own, and just to prove so, I'm going to show you the rest of the library of N64 games that I own. GoldenEye. Star Wars Rogue Squadron. Zelda Majora's Mask. Super Smash Bros. Duke Nukem 64. Star Wars Shadows of the Empire, F-Zero X, and Body Harvest. As you notice, this is version 1.1. Now watch this closely. I'm going to insert this into the game cartridge. I'm going to insert this into the game system, just to show you guys that I am not cheating you at all. And I'm not gonna cut away from this either. Yes, I am going to Lake Hylia. Alright, here we go. I'm purchasing all these things. I'm getting out the fishing rod. Now watch this closely. I'm putting on the hover boots. I'm gonna go and... Oh, look at that! Now he's walking around with the hover boots. This is not supposed to happen in version 1.1, but it is on my copy. Now look at that! I just left with the rod. I am now resetting the system. I'm looking into the light just so you guys can get a good look right here. Notice how there is no sword on the green icon right here? Bet you never saw that one coming, did you? Right now I am heading back to Hyrule Field to get on Epona, the horse. I don't know how her name is pronounced, but I'm just gonna call her Epona. When the sun rises that fast when you play the song, it just really cracks me up. Now I'm using, like, every sea item on her. I can even throw Deku nuts, too. Notice how if I go forward, she goes forward. If I go left or right, she goes left or right. So she just responds to, like, every direction I press in. And no matter how far away, if you press the A button, he magically gets on from that far away. It's really, really funny, I'm telling you. I could even play